What's going on though, people? So I just wanted to pull up on you guys today. Today I'll be sharing my experience of buying a vehicle online through Carvana, so stay tuned. If you're on this video, you're probably looking for some of the same answers that I was looking for. You probably have some of the same questions that I had before I purchased my vehicle, and hopefully I can get some of those questions answered for you. As I'm recording this video, we're actually almost a year in to lockdowns being announced for the first time because of the COVID-19 coronavirus pandemic. Now, we're trying to keep exposure to a minimum the best way we can. We just decided, hey, we're buying everything else online. Why not try buying a car online? And I know it sounds ironic at first sight, but the experience really wasn't that bad. Upon filling out the application, it was kind of weird because it just seemed like it was too easy. The application process was smooth. And if you've purchased a vehicle at a dealership before, you already know how that could be with filling out paperwork for hours. And then your salesman has to go talk to the finance person. The finance person has to go talk to this person. That person has to go talk to another person. And before you know it, you're in the dealership for 5 hours. So that part I definitely didn't miss. First, you'll go through a pre-qualification where you'll just put some basic information, just trying to see if you qualify. There's no hard credit pull at that point. The only time there's a hard credit check is when you actually find the vehicle and you go through with the purchase. All right, so Carvana, they pull from Experian. So that could be a great thing, especially if Experian is your high score. And also what you wanna do is if you have fraud alert, credit alert, or any kind of alert set up on Experian, or if you have your profile locked, it's best to go ahead and just unlock that, take off any alerts that's on your account, because that can definitely hold up the process. That actually happened to me. I had my profile locked and I had alerts set up on my account, and I had to actually pause my application, call Experian, get those alerts moved, unlock the account and all this different stuff. But if I had already had that stuff done, and if I knew that beforehand, then the application process actually would have been a lot smoother. Upon getting all the alerts removed, upon getting the profile unlocked on Experian, we were able to go ahead and move forward with the application. My vehicle of choice was a Mercedes-Benz C300 luxury package, and we chose to go ahead and do pickup since the location was a hop and a skip away from our house. So we just went around the corner, picked up real quick, got the vehicle, signed a few documents, took it for a test drive, loved it. And I loved the fact that we had the 7-day money back guarantee. So you had an opportunity to drive the vehicle around for 7 days. And if you don't like the vehicle, you can actually get you another vehicle or get your money back. If you put a down payment, get that back, or just cancel the process altogether. Now, I know Carvana is good about the 150-point inspection, but I still would highly suggest going to get a diagnostics test, preferably if you're in an area where the manufacturer has a dealership. I would highly suggest going to get a diagnostics test. So what I found upon getting a diagnostics test was my passenger back window, it would let up, but it wouldn't let down. So that's why I highly suggest going to get a diagnostics test so you can figure out if there's any mechanical issues. All right, so as you guys can see, window works, window is good now. Now, the cool thing about it, if it is a mechanical issue, Carvana takes care of it with the Silver Rock program that you're enrolled in for your first 100 days. So if you run into any issues within the first 100 days of owning the vehicle, if it's a mechanical issue, Carvana actually takes care of the bill for you. Another issue that I saw people were running into online as I was doing my research, where people were having an issue with getting a tag. I didn't really have that issue. I went to the dealership, everything was smooth with getting a tag. From the pre-qualification process all the way to where we are now, which I'm about a month into having the vehicle, everything seems pretty good so far. So what I'll actually do for you guys, I'll post another update after the 100 days to kind of see where we are, and then maybe post another update 6 months after having the vehicle. Now, I didn't have a down payment with my purchase, but if you do have a down payment with your purchase, they actually allow you in the process, in the online process while you're purchasing, to actually go ahead and insert your account number, your routing number, and they'll process that ACH for the down payment. And of course, that'll be pulled before your actual pickup date or your delivery date. All right, guys, so if you have a Carvana experience, please share that below in the comments, and please like, share, subscribe if I helped you in any way, answer any of your questions, or send this to somebody if they're thinking about doing a purchase online, preferably through Carvana. All right, guys, so check under the hood here, get some of these leaves out of the way. I know you guys don't care about that though, but everything checked out on the diagnostic test. Like I said, she's a beauty on the outside, but she's also a beauty on the inside as well. So all in all, guys, I give Carvana a 10 out of 10 on this particular experience. 10 out of 10. So I hope you have a good rest of your day. It's Deuce the Dope Dad. I'm signing out.